Hi friends, welcome to Prsoft technical channel. In the C language series, today we are going to see the program number 22. Already we have started with the loops in C language. In that we have seen first loop, that is while, and we have seen one program on while. So in the continuation of while loop, we are going to start with today how to print number from 1 to n and second program from n to 1. Today we will see both the programs. I hope guys you have cleared about your last doubt, that is plus plus and minus minus, which I explained in the last lecture. Now today we will start with the again while loop. So let's start with the video guys. Those both programs are very important for your labs. So let's start with the file. Take a new source file. We'll add here again two header files, hash include stdio.h, hash include conio.h, and then we will add main function and then we'll print the value. Last time we have discussed about like we need one variable I is equals to 1, and one more variable I need n, because last time I told you to print a number from which number to which number you want to print, that is very important. So first number starting is 1 and last number now I need n. If you get 1 to 10 also, we can use the same techniques. So till what number you want to print, that number first you have to read here. So I will tell enter the number. So user will enter one number and till that number you have to print this values. So number, I will take scanf and here I will print this value. I will read this value and I will store into n. Now in the while loop, what we have to do, while we have to write what condition. So now in the condition, starting value is I less than or equals to n, means what, I value will repeat until it now become n. So let's print, what you have to print, number only. So I will write here percentile d and I will use slash n. Guys, here percentile d, what value you will pass to percentile d, we need from 1 to n, nothing but starting value is I. So I will take here I and take a semicolon. And then we have to write I plus plus. Why we have to write? To increment. Just let's start with one. Just I will try to explain this. Just see here. We have taken value I initially is 1. And we are reading, suppose example, I will give n value is 5. You can take any value guys, it's not a problem. Then it will come to while loop and it will check the condition. 1 less than or equals to 5. Condition true. And it will we are printing what, I value. I value is how much, 1. So it will print on the screen 1. Then I plus plus, I value will become how much, 2 value. Then again it will not come out as I told till this value become false. In you have to remember, you use any loop will execute until it not become false. So it again it will come I less than or equals to 5, nothing but 2 less than or equals to 5. Condition true, it will come inside, it will print I value. Now I value is how much, 2. So it will print on the screen. I plus plus, I value will become 3. Again 3 less than or equals to 5, condition true, it will print 3. Again I plus plus, again I plus plus, I value will become 4. 4 less than or equals to 5, condition true, again it will come on the screen, it will print 4. Then I plus plus, I value will become 5. 5 less than or equals to 5, condition true. If you give here less than, it will print up to 4. But if you are given less than or equals to 5, so it will print 5 also. Now I value will become 6. 6 less than or equals to 5, condition false, and it will come out. So finally what we will get on the screen, 1 to 5, if we give the value 5. Now go to execute, compile the program. It is asked me to save, so I will give, last time w.c we have given, this time we will give w2.c, nothing but in the while loop second program we are seeing. Now go to execute and run the program. I will give the value first time 5. So see, 1 to 5 you are getting. Now you give any value, there is no restriction for the value. I can give 50, it will print 1 to 50. You can see here all the value we got it. Now if you want to print 1000, you can print 1000 also. See, 1000 we got it. So like this we can print the values from 1 to n. So now if you want to print what, n to 1, so how we will write? So just I will this program I will copy and paste to new file guys, okay, and I will try to explain the code once again. So just I will write while loop once again. I will not do changes inside because we need starting value, we need ending value, and we have to read one number from 1 to n or n to 1. Both are same. See, I told you, first I will explain you what 1 to n. So we have finished with 1 to n. Now n to 1 is nothing but, suppose if I give 5, so it should print 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the screen. So many people do lot of mistake when they use the while loop, and especially when they want to print in reverse order. They will do like I is equals to n value, they will pass and they will do some plus plus minus minus, but we don't want. Guys, one thing you have to remember, you go from 1 to n or n to 1, number of repetitions are same. So I will not change the condition, I will make the same, I will write the same condition. Okay, now in the print of first we were printing what I value, because we have to print, we have to starting value, we need what 1, but now we need what n value. Okay, so I will write here n, and here I will write semicolon. So now n should come to 1, nothing but minus minus. Suppose we have to write n minus minus. First time it is 4, then 3, 2, 1, like this. Just come to code. I will take the similar code which we have taken last time. Now see, initially I value is 1 and we are imagining this n value 5. Now it will come I less than or equals to n, nothing but 1 less than 5, condition true. It will on the screen, it will go and it will print the n value. Now previously it was printing I value, so it 1 was coming. Now it is n value 5 or 5 will come. Now n minus 1 is means nothing but n value will decrease to 1, it will be 4. Now again 1 less than or equals to 4, condition true, it will come inside, it will print the value of n 4. Then again n minus minus, it will become 3. 3 less than or equals to 1, oh sorry, 1 less than or equals to 3, condition true, it will print the 3. Then this value become n minus minus 2, then it will check the 1 less than 2, true, 1 less than or equals to true, it will print 2 value. Then it will come inside again, print value n minus minus, n value will become what, 1. Now it will come 1 less than or equals to 1, still it is true, it will come, it will print the value of 1. Again n minus minus, it will become 0. Now 0, 1 less than or equals to 0, condition false, it will come out and it will stop the program. Guys, I hope you are understanding this diagrammatic concept. Once again I will go to compile and I will save the program with w3.save because this is third program. So go to execute, once again run the program. Now we are giving 5 value once again. Now see 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Similarly, we can give any number whichever you want. Even you, if you want 1000, you can give 1000. See, it is printing in reverse order till 1. So like this, we can print guys from 1 to n or n to 1. Both we can execute guys. I hope you understand this program. Still, if you are having any doubts, please mail me or comment me. So I will solve your doubt. Thank you for watching my video guys. And one more thing guys, if you do not subscribe till now, please subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.